today we are here with our official sommelier and wine expert, Mattia Pellegrini, who is going to tell us what is unique about growing wine in Cinque Terre.
So what is unique about making wine in Cinque Terre is that for centuries, people have been growing wine in terraces. These terraces goes down all the way to the sea, up from the mountains. In the old times, they used to carry the grapes by boat, but nowadays, it is not anymore needed to carry the grapes by boat, but people here in the Cinque Terre, they use different type of technology, which is this type of machine, which is called cremagliera. And so they use this one to carry grapes all the way up in the mountains. Let me say a few words. What you see down there is the town of Manarola, which is one of the five villages of Cinque Terre.
And tell us about the unique harvesting technique in this area.
So what is unique in this area is that in most of the Italian lands, the plants are aligned. Here the plants, as you can see, they're not aligned, but they are carved. And what is unique is that you cannot use machine. So what they need to do, you need to go underneath and you have to harvest from underneath. And so it takes place all manually. So these are the grapes and it's manually harvested.
Interesting.
This picture was taken in 1981, just 37 years ago, and you can easily see that almost all the two hills above Manarola were completely cultivated. And now, in 2018, we have lost more than 50% of the terraces, and we are working with other wine growers to rebuild and to restore all the terraces and the drying stone walls along the coast, because we need for safety of the village and to produce more wine and better quality than in 1981.
At the end of the 1800s, a grape called Bosco came to this area, probably from a valley near Genoa, a very cold valley where it did not grow very well. But then they noticed it grew very well here. So when an outbreak of phylloxera arrived, they stopped growing another grape called Rossese Bianco and substituted it with Bosco, which grew in much greater quantity. So today the main grapes of the Cinque Terre are Bosco, Vermentino, and Albarola, whereas before it was Albarola, Vermentino, and Rossese Bianco.
The name of the producer is Marzia. She's a woman, and this is a particularity because in Cinque Terre the winemakers are mainly men. And so she started to produce her own wine to bring back also women to the vineyards and to spread her idea of wine, of local wine.
The grapes variety used in this wine are Bosco, Albarola and Vermentino. It goes entirely in oak, with several kinds of wood used in this process. The aroma is very sophisticated, it's not too intense, but extremely elegant, as it should be.
It's still a white wine called Cappellini, so Cinque Terre blend, Vermentino Bosco Albarola, and he called this wine Tradizione, tradition. So he want to remember the tradition of the inhabitants when they separate the skins from the moss to make the wine. So this is like a kind of a method of red wine to remind, like a tradition, like more flavor inside. You will see the color. The color is really gold. It's really a strong color. And the flavor. The flavor is not like an easy white wine that you just drink and you say, yes, it's good. In this one, you need to talk. In this one, you need to wait. You need to sip and you need to taste.
This is Amoges. It's Primatera wine. It's made of the classic Cinque Terre grape types, so Bosco, Albarola, Vermentino, but as you see by the color, it's completely different from the other white wines we had before. It's an orange wine, it's really orange. So that comes from a longer maceration of the skins with the juice, and a longer persistence and of the juice and of the wine in a wooden barrel. So you have it in the big barrels, 500 liter barrels for about 1.5 years. So it takes also its color from its aging, from the wood, and of course from the maceration of the skins, because it's on the skins that and that's our message. That's a Mediterranean kind of winemaking, that you leave your juice on the skins, because on the skins you have the territory.
It's really good sensation, you know, when a wine not just finish when you sip it, but you can still feel it for a long time. This is an experience that lasts for a long period.
Are you ready, Beth?
Yeah.
Go.
Can I have some help here?
Manu. Okay. She's knocking her in.
Okay. Okay, guys, now we can stop. Well done. All of you made a really good pesto. And I'm really happy today because all of you made a good pesto.